You are praying that, Lord, may you open me up to understand your word this moment. You open me up to understand your word. Kata pale bele ya talababe, reka pale babe, lebele ya talababa, reka pale baba, lebede kata, razebele ya talababa, lebekapa. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Father God, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for the opportunity given us to come before you and to study in the name of Jesus of you. You are teaching us about your kingdom in the name of Jesus. And we say we all ears in the name of Jesus this morning. That as we come, may you pour the deep in the name of Jesus. Your word declares that the deep calleth unto the deep. As we yearn, Lord my God, so shall you give unto us. As we want to know more, you will never stop us from teaching us and letting us know more about you. For as we desire deep, Lord my God, deep will be our portion. In the name of Jesus, we are praying right now that, Lord, may we never live here the same. Teach us, Lord my God. Equip us so that we'll be able to walk worthy of our calling as your followers. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, and may all the saints say amen. We thank God for today, online church. God bless you for joining in once again. We are here for another wonderful time of teaching, and our man of God is ready, prepared to walk us through and to enlighten us, to bring the deep things of God unto us. Today we're looking at the principles of the kingdom of God. The principles of the kingdom of God. We've been talking about the kingdom of God. What it is. When was it established? How we supposed to work it? There are principles. If you know all about it, negating the principles, how would you benefit thereof? Amen. So today I believe that this is timely. The year is new. And I believe if you want to get to where God wants us to get to, there are things we're supposed to really get hold of. Amen. Because we don't want to get to December and be like, I wish I had started this way. Amen. I wish I had done it this way. In the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, the principles of the kingdom of God. Hopefully, if God willing and we have time, we'll keep going. I'm looking at the notes here and the pointers. It's a double page, part one and part two. So as God gives us the opportunity, we'll keep going. I want you to continue tuning in, even as we bring the man of God to the podium. We welcome to the podium once again, Evangelist Colt.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastor, I thank you very much for your hospitality and your concern about the kingdom. I'm very proud of you, Pastor. If you are new, let me put you in this way. Go back. I put kingdom of God 1 and 2, 3, kingdom of God 3, all the parts. So about 18 parts are there. So if you go on to see one by one, then you will learn more about the kingdom. Once you understand the kingdom, you will operate the kingdom of God, and you will establish the kingdom of God on earth as it is in the heaven. And also you know how to get your deliverance. Today onwards, maybe 4 parts will be, maybe 4 or 5, I don't know. Depends the time. I'm going to preach about the principle of the kingdom of God, or principle of the kingdom of heaven. You can say kingdom of heaven and kingdom of God, so both are the same. Only the difference is Matthew saying the kingdom of heaven. Only Matthew say 32 times. And he said 5 times kingdom of God also in the book of Matthew. Rest of all the books, even Luke, Mark, John is saying kingdom of God. And the rest of Apostle Paul and everybody is preach about the kingdom of God. So they never say about the kingdom of heaven, because the audience of Matthew is focusing only Jewish people or people of Israel. That's why. Now, why Jesus came this planet as a human? And also, Jesus is always saying, I am Son of Man. It's very important. So before I am going through these words, I'm greeting all of you, and especially one who is on online and Facebook and YouTube watches, and also one is in the church and the pastor. Everybody, I'm greeting all of you in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Today, principle part one. Why Jesus came this planet? What was the major theme of his coming? What is the second coming? What is his major theme? Everybody say, Lord is coming back. What is the purpose of coming? He already established his kingdom. That is a spiritual kingdom. It's already established. Now he is going to establish his a literal kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God in this planet, in this world. Is that right, Pastor? Yes. He is going to rule and reign in Jerusalem. He is going to sit on the throne of David. And he came here to talk about his kingdom, how it is working, what we have to do. 2 days, about last week, I guess, I met a man. He's in India. He's a well educated in degree in theology. When I talk about the kingdom, he said he wanted to take PhD about theology. I said, that is well and good. But degree is everything good, but do you think in the Bible college, anybody teach about the kingdom of God? And he said, no, only some Jesus story about the kingdom. Now, brothers and sisters, what is the purpose of Jesus came on this planet? He himself is revealed. We can read in Luke chapter 4 verse 43. Pastor, would you be able to put it on the screen? And we will, everybody can see it, and we will read it together too. Any version, no problem. Luke chapter 4 verse 43.
And I read, And he said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore I am sent. Amen.
Okay. I can read it, and I want you to read it. You know why? Because one or two people say together, then it will be established.
Yes.
Why Jesus came in this planet? It's a major reason. Jesus said, I am sent only one thing for. You know, every time when I ask the people say, oh, to remove our sins. That is why Jesus came. That is one part. Hello? That is one part. It is not the full part.
Yes. Okay?
The reason he came to establish his kingdom, and also he came and he said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also. For therefore I am sent. He is claiming, I am sent only one thing for.
Yes.
To preach the kingdom of God everywhere. So what is the purpose of you and me? Why he taken out from this world? To preach the kingdom of God. But unfortunately, major part of the Christianity is not preaching the kingdom of God. I don't know, maybe they don't understand the kingdom of God, they don't know, they don't get the revelation of the kingdom of God. But a few of them were preaching. But Jesus said, whole world will be preached. In their world will be preached the kingdom of God. Then the end will come.
Yes, Lord.
So, in India, especially my state, about 100 years, 125 years now, the Pentecostal people are preaching, Jesus is coming. Still 125 years, Jesus never show up.
Yes.
And I'm showing to them, I'm telling them, why Jesus did not come yet? Because very few people are preaching the kingdom of God. They are establishing their own kingdom, not the kingdom of God. So, principle we are going to learn. Luke, Mark, and Matthew. Only there is a lot of parables are there. And all the parables we are not going. And I teach of all the parables, and I teach them, and I put it in YouTube. In my language, in Malayalam, but the parables, this is the parable, is very important parable. Then you, once you learn the principle, you will understand this is the most important parable. The sowing seed, everybody know, all Christianity is preaching, sometimes. Once in a while, people will preach. But very few of them that understand the sowing seed parable. Okay, now we are going to Luke. We start with the Luke. Luke chapter 8 verse 1. Can you read for me, please?
The book of Luke, the chapter number 8, the verse number 1.
Mm-hmm.
And I read.
Mm.
And it came to pass afterward that he went throughout every city and village, preaching and showing the glad tidings of the kingdom of God. And the 12 were with him.
Okay, where did he went? All cities, everywhere. He preached what?
The kingdom.
Kingdom of God. And good news of the kingdom of God. So what is the good news? What is the gospel? The kingdom of God. If you ask anybody, any Christianity, what is the good news? Oh, Jesus died and buried and rose up. That's what they are saying about it. Jesus did not say about the kingdom. That is the good news. That is good news. But that is not the all good news. Good news is about the kingdom of God.
Amen.
I don't know how to explain this one. You know, when I hear from Miles Monroe, he talking about why Jesus came. He well established preaching that one.
Uh-huh.
You ever heard from him about that one? So, because you should know what is the purpose of Jesus came to this planet? One purpose, to preach the kingdom of God and establish the kingdom of God and explain to the people the kingdom of God and give you the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Verse number 4.
Verse number 4.
And
when much people were gathered together
and
were come to him out of every city, He spoke by a parable.
Okay. He spoke by parables. I saw 46 parables in the Word of God. In all Gospels, especially Synoptic Gospels, if you see it, most of the parables you can see it. Out of these parables, this is a very important parable he is going to read. And can you read the sower went?
And I read. A sower went out to sow his seed. And as he sowed, some fell by the wayside. And it came and it was trodden down. And the fowls of the air devoured it. Verse 6. And some fell upon a rock, and as soon as it was sprung up, it withered away because it lacked moisture. Verse 7. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up with it and choked it. And others fell on good ground and sprang up and bare fruit on hundredfold. And when he had said these things, he cried, "He that had ears to hear, let him hear."
Okay, thank you.
Amen.
Finally, he said, after he said the parable, he said, "Let them have ears, let them hear." What is that meaning? What did you understand? What is the meaning of that one? What is the meaning of that one?
You can say those who have understand, or those who are ready. Let them take what I'm saying.
Yeah. Whatever I'm saying, make sure you understand it. He knew everybody have the ears. Only few of them are not here, they are dumb. But most of them are, they have the ears and they can hear it. But Jesus is saying, you very carefully understand what I am saying. You know about the sowing the seed. When you sow some seed, and some fell on the wayside. Who took it? Wayside, the fly or the birds of the air, they come and grab it. Some fell on the rocky place. Some fell on the thorns. Some fell on the good ground. You know the story. You don't know the understanding of that one. That is the principle we need to learn. Why Jesus is preach this principle? Because the earth principle is very important. This is the way everything is growing. That is the principle of Genesis. Seed time and harvest time, if you don't understand it, you don't get anything out of this world. People, how you think about this? In this world, this earth, whatever you can get it from this earth, nobody taken away from here. People are gathering so many things and gather and file it up, and then they die and they go. They don't know what happened next. Whatever you gather in this world, it will be in the world. That's it. World will, how long this world was? Think about it. How many people live in this planet and die? One day, someday, somebody will take in something from here. The earth lost anything? Yes, brother? Earth lost anything? Nothing lost. Anything finished in this planet?
No.
Oh my God. Lord created this earth. Everything have a seed. Everything have seed. And it produces as needed. That is the way Lord created. He is not creating anymore. He is rusted after his creation. It means he is not more creating. You are telling, Lord, you do something, you do something. Lord is not going to do anything. He finished every work. Jesus said at the cross what he said. It's finished. People are saying, Lord, you do something, you do something. That's a prayer. People are thinking that is a prayer. That is a prayer. That's not a prayer. That is a murmuring, complaining. You do something, it means he didn't do anything for you. He did everything for you. So, next portion we are going to learn very slowly. If I say fast, you don't understand anything. This is the parable you need to very carefully learn. Then you understand principle of the kingdom of God. Pastor, can you read 10 and 2:15?
And he said unto you, it is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God, but to others in parables.
Okay, hold on. I want to go by word by word. Because he said, to you given the mystery. What is the meaning of mystery? Mystery means hidden things. Mysteries of the parable. Are the secrets of the kingdom. Secrets of the kingdom of God, but others are as a parable. So think about it. How many people came there? Thousands of people came there to listen. How many?
Thousands.
And Jesus talk about parable. Without parable, he doesn't say anything. So, and he's saying to the disciples, hey, you 12, you got the secrets. Others does not get it. You tell me. So, how do you get it? As a parable or the mystery? Do you get the secrets of the kingdom of God? So, it means there is some secrets hide in this parable. Is that right? So thousands of people, they did not get it. Then who got it? Disciples. Who is disciples? One time I asked somebody in a meeting, what is the meaning of parable, disciple? What do you learn about the principle? What is the meaning of disciple? You know, he said, one person said, one who have discipline, they are disciples. The word come from disciple, come from the discipline. And I said, if you want to have a disciplined life, why you want to go to Christianity? Go to the police department, go to military, they will teach you how to be disciplined. Discipline is not disciple. Disciple is an academic word. The teacher and the student. Teacher and the student. That the word is called a disciple. Not discipline. If you understand the academical word, then only you understand that one. Otherwise, you will say in any kind of language, people of God, Jesus talked to his students, saying, you are my student, and you will get the secrets. Next word, 11.
Verse 11. Now the parable is this. The seed is the word of God.
Okay, seed is what?
The word of God.
Okay, very simple. Seed is the word of God. Okay, next.
The verse number 12. Those by the wayside are they that hear. then cometh the devil and taketh away the word out of their heart, lest they should believe and be saved.
Okay, what is that meaning? Because when you hear the word of God, before your understanding, they will come inside of you and he taken away from you. Why he is taken away from you? Hey, brother, Jesus said, thief come to steal, kill and destroy. Why he is stealing the word of God? I don't understand. Why he want to steal the word of God from you? Why? Hello? This is the part you may understand that. If you know the word of God, if you understand the word of God, if you use the word of God, Satan lose one person from his kingdom. What happened? Satan loses one person from the kingdom of God. That is why he is stealing. He is taking away the word of God while it is sown in your heart. That is the wayside. Who said it? Jesus said it. I didn't say that. Did I say that?
No.
Most of the preachers, I'm not blaming them, they interpret this word their own way. Is that right, Pastor? They interpret their own way.
Yes.
Not the Jesus style. That is why they don't understand the secrets. If you need to understand the word of God, you need to know what is Jesus is saying about it. Verse number
13. The verse number 13. They on the rock are they which when they hear receive the word with joy, and these have no root, which for a while believe, and in the time of temptation fall away.
Okay. Jesus is interpreting the 13th word. He is saying, this is a rocky side. They receive the word of God with the joy and they say, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, and clapping the hands. They receive the word of God. Very joy. And also, they will go outside. Oh, brother, what happened yesterday? Why don't you come to the meeting? What happened? Oh, such a fiery meeting. Wonderful meeting. The man of God came from so and so place. Oh man, it's fire. Everybody get blessed. Everybody get what?
Blessed.
And then you can ask him, what was the theme? Oh, he preached.
They forget, yeah.
Wait a minute. I know. It's on my tongue. Right now, why did I tell you? Oh my God. Did you see those kind of people?
Yeah.
That is a rocky side. Next one.
The verse number 14.
The
Bible says, and that which fell among the thorns are they which when they have heard go forth and are choked with cares and riches and pleasures of this life and bring no fruit to perfection. Amen.
The third person is in the thorns. Jesus is saying they are also the same thing. With a good pleasure they hear the word of God, and also they look at the watch, and the watch over there, and they look at the pastor.
You have to finish early.
Yeah. You know, today there is a sports, there is a football is there. There is a something meeting is there. I have to go for overtime.
Yeah.
I have to go for purchase the car. He is busy with the worldly stuff. He is busy with what?
With the worldly stuff, the pleasures of the world.
What is the benefit for him? He also went to for what? The meeting. Hear the word of God. There is any benefit out of it? No, brother. He's not getting any benefit. Next one.
The verse number 15. But that on the good ground are they which in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience. Amen.
Okay. What is that meaning? What is the meaning of good ground? Your heart. When the word of God fell on your heart, it will grow slowly. It will grow slowly. If you plant a seed on the ground, how it is growing? Slowly. It's not rapidly coming. Grow slowly. It will take time. Grow slowly and grow up, and it will produce its own fruit. It produces what?
Fruit.
Its own fruit. So, now tell me, the fruit coming from where? Your heart or from the heaven?
From your heart.
So who are to produce the healing? Hello?
Your heart.
Who have to produce the healing? Who have to produce your goodness? Who have to produce your money? Who are to produce your riches? Hello? Lord is not going to put to your head. He's not going to pour out everything. He already poured out everything. Now your job to produce. That is why he given you the word of God. Now, I know this 15 to 20 minutes, you don't understand anything. I know that. Now, I'm going to say something about Mark and Matthew. I'm going to bring up with something else. In between here, Jesus said about Luke chapter 8 verse 10. Can you read that one more time?
Luke chapter 8, the verse number 10.
Uh-huh.
And I read.
And then 9 also, 9 also.
Okay, take it from 9 to 10. Mm-hmm. The verse number 9.
Mm.
And his disciples asked him, saying, what might this parable be?
Okay, they are asking, what is the meaning of this parable? Okay, next.
The verse number 10.
And
he said, unto you it is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God, but to others in parables, that seeing they might not see, and hearing they might not understand.
Okay. Now, this portion, we have to pull it out from Matthew and Mark, learn a little bit more. This section. So, go to Matthew chapter 10 to 12.
And the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? The verse number 11. He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. The verse number 12. For whosoever hath, to him shall be given, and he shall have more abundance. But whosoever hath not, from him shall be taken away, even that he hath.
Okay. Very, Very carefully, you need to read and study this portion. Disciples come to ask, he asked Jesus, Matthew, Mark, Luke, you can see that they are asking. And they are asking, Jesus is explaining to them, for you, the given, the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, and for them, it is not. Why not? Lord, you came here to give everybody everything. Then why don't you let them to understand that? The secrets are given unto you, for them not. They have it, they will get abundantly. They have not, it will be whatever here, they have it taken away. It means they have not, means if they will listen, they don't understand it, it will be taken away from him because they are not using. See, I don't know how many of you understand what Jesus is saying. It's a little hard to understand. That is why this Jesus' explanation, you know why Jesus is saying that? Jesus said in Matthew chapter 12, 48, thank you.
And said, and behold,
behold,
greater than Solomon is here.
Greater than Solomon is here. What is that meaning?
I'm greater than Solomon.
Solomon is the greatest man of the wisdom. Now, Jesus is talking more than the wisdom over here. For you thinking for sowing the seed is a story. But he is talking about the kingdom of heaven. He's talking about the kingdom of God's secrets. So what do you think? You have to learn very carefully what is Jesus is teaching. For 2-3 apart, when you learn about this one, then you may understand probably what is the meaning of the secrets of the parable. Okay, Matthew 13 and verse 13 and 14. 13 and 14. Can you read for me, please?
The verse number 13 and 14.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore speak I to them in parables. Because they see not, and hearing they hear not, neither do they understand.
Oh my God! They're hearing, hear not. They're seeing, they see not. Why? They're hearing, they understand. The word understand, you underline the portion. If you want to learn about the Jesus teaching, three things you may understand. One, understand meaning. You may go through the dictionary and what is the meaning of understand. Other one, knowledge. Other thing is wisdom. Three words is very important in this word of God. Once you understand the word of God, it will generate the more production. You will produce more fruit. Most of the Christian people, they want the knowledge of the word of God. Knowledge is itself, it's not good. But wisdom is coming from heavenly place, from God. What is the meaning is, the time comes, you use the word of God. If you want to use the word of God, you must understand the word of God. Then only you can use it. Okay, verse number 14.
Verse number 14. And in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, which saith, by hearing ye shall hear, and shall not understand, and seeing ye shall see, and shall not perceive.
15.
Verse 15. For this people's heart is waxed gross, and their ear are dull of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest at any time they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears. Amen.
And understand in their
heart. And should understand with their heart, and should be converted, and I should heal them.
Why people are not healing?
You don't understand.
Hello. People are saying, pray, you cry unto the Lord. Cry. Let the tears come out from your eyes. All the tears is gathered together and put it in the heavenly places. Tears will not heal you. Crying unto the Lord will not heal you. Bible never say about it. That is the religious way. The healing is here. You must understand the word of God and use the word of God. I'm closing this section right now because next 2-3 sections, once you understand the word of God, it will give you the principle of the kingdom of God. May God bless you. These words, may richly bless you.
We thank God for such a time. The principles of the kingdom of God. Everything is embedded in scriptures. And the clue, the insight, the assignment, or the way by which you imbibe into the principles is by seeking it. You can't get it. You can't get it. And I beg to differ. You can't get to operate the principles of the kingdom by impartation. You have to seek it. The prophet that were even gifted, the Bible says that it was hidden from them. Jesus had to reveal it. We thank God for this thing. Amen. It is very crucial, because if you don't have the principles, you wouldn't be able to operate effectively. The principle is how it works. The principle is how it works. You don't seek the kingdom in the second place, sorry. The kingdom cannot be in the second position. It is supposed to be first. So if you don't understand the principle, you will be doing other things and later the kingdom, and it will not work. So Jesus said something. He said, for where your treasure is, there your heart is. So if you put your treasure first, it means that your heart is with your treasure. If the principles. Pastor Claude, God bless you. I know you are encouraged to learn more, to search for it. And as you search for it, the Bible says that you will what? Find. You will find. That is the clue. It is not by impartation. Jesus was with the disciples. He says, who do men say I am? You will answer. Say, who do you? The men are saying it. But who do you say I am? And then the Bible said, Peter began to speak. And he said, you know what? It is not any man that has revealed this thing to you. It is from above. And upon this revelation, the understanding, the revelation, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. Why? Because you are operating the principle. It is God first. God is teaching you things. And if God, you see, when you talk about that scripture, the gates of hell will not prevail against it, because I'm building my church upon this revelation. Why would the gate not be able to prevail again? Because God is teaching you.
you are not listening from the kingdom principles. On that note, God bless you. I pray online. I pray that you will take in this thing. You breathe it in. Assimilate it. Let it be part of your inner being. And you walk by it. In the mighty name of Jesus. One thing I pray. May the grace be available unto you. Even as you desire. You desire to understand. What God wants you to understand. May the grace be available. May you be strengthened to be able to walk worthy of your calling in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that they were not even healed because the understanding is not there. If you don't understand, the healing is not coming to you. You cannot produce the fruit if you don't have the seed in you. But as you've taken in the seed, I pray, may you water it by the reading of the word and pray. And may it begin to bear the fruit, healing all over your body, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray. Amen. God bless you for joining in online. We appreciate you. Church in the house, we appreciate you. Same time next week, we'll be coming your way for Bible teaching. And I know God will continue to be a blessing unto you. Shalom, peace be unto you. Amen.